Hello, hi, zdravo, привет. Today we will be cooking a classic Russian dish. It's a soup that's red, and every Russian knows what I'm talking about. It's called borscht. It's rustic, but not as simple as it seems. It's very tasty and very beautiful. For that we will need some stuff for the stock, beef or chicken, maybe even vegetable stock will do. I will be cooking with beef today. Potatoes, I have red ones here, any types will do, white ones probably would be better. Carrot, an onion, beets, tomato paste, I don't have it, I forgot to buy it. I will be making my own today. And cabbage. White one is preferable. Everyone uses white. This was the smallest one I could buy. And I wouldn't even need as much. Probably like a third. So we'll see how that turns out. I've cut all the vegetables. Medium cut potatoes. The onions and the carrot. As well as using this thing. I forgot what it's called, and ground the beetroot. Finely chop the tomatoes for the paste. You won't need that if you buy it. And about a third of the cabbage piece. I cut it as finely as I could, but not too fine. I used the knife and it's pretty rough cut. Right away, the potatoes go into the stock. Then all the other vegetables I'm going to fry. These ones will be fried together. Then afterwards, these two will be fried together. Afterwards, the cabbage will go into the soup, the last. Because if we do it too soon, then it would break apart and it's going to be just a mess. I have finished frying the onions and the carrots. By the way, this step is completely unnecessary. About 90% of Russians do not ever fry them before they put them into the borscht soup. As well as the restaurants that I've been to and worked at. So they look like this. And they might seem burned, but I've heard a rumor that this state of these vegetables put into the borscht make it so much better. The beetroot and tomato are done now, and you can see their state here. I tried not to overfry them. The next step is to add some lemon juice. And we are not throwing away this lemon yet. Now I'm checking the state of the cabbage that I put in about a 30 minute ago time period. Mine was cut quite a bit larger than I hoped it to be, so I've put it for a longer time. Now it's done. I'm adding some salt. It needs quite a bit of salt. And all this redness comes in. By the way, most people don't fry this. They just put it fresh and they put it first before even the potatoes. And you can see the color already. Adding a bit of black pepper and some crushed one as well. keeping it on the low heat for now, and in half an hour it will be complete. And then I will add a piece of lemon like this, and it will be complete. By the way, there was and still is quite a bit of a fight between the Ukrainians and Russians on whose soup it is. But during the old times, like the 14th century or something, when it was the Kievan Rus, the soup was made without the potatoes and without the beetroot, but it was made with something else that is poisonous. It's called borshchevik in Russian, therefore the name of the soup, borscht. I will display the name of the plant on the screen. The recipe changed a lot, and this way that I'm cooking this right now, not many people cook it that way. Almost everyone has their own way, but the result is almost the same. And also this soup gets a lot better as the days go by, and because it has lemon in it, it will stay good and fresh for at least 5 days or more. It's best served with rye bread, or black bread as it's called in Russian, and sour cream that you put on the bread or in the soup. Thank you everybody for watching. That was very strange and fun, because I made it just completely different. I will put the recipe in the description below. Thank you, bye bye. Malinka, 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 malinka.